In the last year to 18 months, the financial services industry, the global economy, has been through a one in a 200-year event.
Chris Cummings is Director General of the Association of Independent Financial Advisors, representing 85% of the UK's 30,000 IFAs, and described on its website as the voice of the profession, lobbying for a light-touch regulatory structure. So what does Mr. Cummings say to investors, many of whom put their money into capital-secure schemes on his members' recommendation, only to see it disappear?
The Financial Ombudsman Service has just published its latest set of complaints generally about the financial services industry. Independent financial advisors account for less than 3% of all complaints at the Ombudsman. And those people who do complain, well, two in three of those complaints go in favour of the firm. If I take Lehman's as an example, it was a bank that's been around for over 180 years. It's been given the highest investment and credit ratings by all the ratings agencies. There are simply levels of due diligence, levels of credibility that I think we now apply that 18 months, 2 years ago, simply wouldn't have been open for discussion. It's rather like suggesting that the UK government could default. There are things that you have to take as solid and stable. And many IFAs did the right thing by advising their clients to come out of more risky investments to go into things that were backed by organisations that had been around for 180 years. Because of a decision by the Bush government, that organisation fell. Well, I think there are just times when we have to say there are things that nobody could possibly anticipate.
But, I mean, anybody who gives financial advice has a duty to treat customers fairly, to be clear about the pros and the cons of any financial product they sell. Is it fair, is it clear to sell a financial product to a customer without properly explaining to them that they could lose all their money if a bank guaranteeing that investment goes bust?
Well, it's in nobody's interest to advise a client to take out an investment that they don't understand. Clients must understand not only what the potential upsides are, but also the scale of detriment if things go wrong. The last 18 months, the financial services world has been turned on its head. And I think that is really at the heart of many of the problems that have been identified, that organisations for whom trust and confidence wouldn't have been a problem have seen really the basis of how they do business fundamentally challenged. The world is much less of a certain place than it was.
Also uncertain is the chance of investors getting any money back. As unsecured creditors of Lehman's, they've joined a long queue. But what about the Financial Services Compensation Scheme, the UK's statutory fund of last resort for customers of authorised financial services firms? It offers the kind of protection which helped persuade Peter Howard from Oxfordshire to take out an NDFA fixed income growth plan last summer.
I always look for that. It's one of the major things that anyone should look for.
And is there anything in that brochure there about the financial services compensation?
Yes, there's an extremely large paragraph at the back. Would you like me to read it to you?
Please.
If you make a valid claim against the plan manager or your financial advisor in respect of the investments arranged for you under these terms and conditions, and they are unable to meet their liabilities in full, you will be entitled to compensation from the Financial Services Compensation Scheme. It goes on to explain how it's made up, but basically it's to a maximum of £48,000. That's the reason I only invested £50,000.
But that reassured you, seeing that?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. I was, you know, I understand there was a risk because the product was related to stock markets, but I thought I was covered should the business go bust. And you look at the back, and it says here, clear black and white, NDFA is authorised and regulated by the Financial Services Authority. And that, again, gives me confidence.
But the Financial Services Compensation Scheme told us its rules don't allow it to help people, like Peter Howard, because the plan managers they used are still trading. And the scheme only pays out where no one else can, because a company has crashed. If consumers had bought products directly from Lehman Brothers, which has crashed, then the compensation scheme could consider their complaint.
We live in the UK, we are UK investors, we invested in a UK company, and we've got a UK financial services compensation scheme. I think that the four go together.
So, with that avenue closed, investors who've lost out are in the hands of the Financial Ombudsman Service. Financial advisor Ralph Patterson believes it offers hope for those with genuine complaints. The only problem is sorting them out.
Whenever you get a situation where a fairly high-profile product fails, such as is the case here, the FOS get a greater workload as a result of it. So the normal 6 to 9 months will probably stretch to 9 to 12 months.
And that's not the only delay, because those complaints registered with the Ombudsman have been put on hold while the Financial Services Authority investigates the issues you've heard about today. Just last week, the FSA asked the Ombudsman to wait for another 3 months. The FSA refused to be interviewed because of its current investigation, but said its work will allow it to explore all options to achieve the best outcome for consumers. It is aware that some investors have lost income and says it's committed to resolving this as soon as practicable. And as for the Financial Services Compensation Scheme, well, the FSA told us it's essential that providers clearly disclose at the outset whether someone will have access to the scheme. It's assessing the clarity of provider literature as part of its review. Paul Wheeler is not holding his breath.
It's really the responsibility of the FSA, who have spent a long time on this, and I know they're very busy, but really, I don't think people realise the amount of damage that these cases do to the reputation of the savings industry in the UK. And there's a lot to make up for.
Face the Facts was presented by John Waite. The producer was John Douglas. Now, the actor Timothy West presents the Radio 4 appeal on behalf of the Blood Pressure Association.
It was the perfect August bank holiday.